Collection features have become the dominant method for creating long-term progressions in casino apps. They were casino's most released feature type in the past 12 months by far, accounting for more than 1.5 times as many releases as missions and 9 times as many as challenges. Unfortunately, collections had the worst revenue market share impact of any progression feature, with collection releases averaging a 1.9% reduction in revenue market share month over month. Ouch. Collections may be having a lackluster impact because they almost always take a similar approach. Players earn items from base play that fill seasonal album pages. Each item typically provides some small reward when earned, and completed album pages provide larger rewards. It's a nice progression of short, medium, and long-term reward schedules, but this formula has been around for a while and probably isn't blowing too many minds these days. As player bases mature, they can handle more complex systems, and they're eager for more active engagement. Enter Fish and Chips, a new pet collection feature in Bingo Bash. The bingo subgenre is something of an incubator for imaginative meta features, so it's not too surprising to see it try out something new here. In this feature, players earn fish by winning bingos on special cards, which they can then feed in timed intervals with food collected by daubing fish food cells. The ability to regularly feed pets to collect rewards is interesting in itself, but Bingo Bash takes the collection's active mechanics even further by only allowing players to place 10 fish in their aquarium at any one time. Because each fish has different feeding requirements, rewards, and reset timers, this restriction creates a collection that's both more strategic and more personalized. Players can choose the costs and rewards that best allow them to pursue their current goals, resulting in compelling decisions that have real consequences for other game systems. The aquarium mechanic also builds a solid foundation for future innovations, like additional pet interactions, upgrades, event-exclusive fish, or even aquarium decorations. Bingo Bash could take this collection even further by giving players a way to show off their fish collections. Although the bingo subgenre focuses on social play, most apps have few, if any, options for publicly visible customization. This kind of public personalization is powerful, as it creates feelings of competence and relatedness to others, which are two of the key components of intrinsic motivation. It has the added benefit of making the rewards more desirable to players who don't have them and encouraging those players to find out how to earn them. For example, Bingo Bash could let players display their favorite fish in their profiles, share images on social media, or visit each other's aquariums. Viewing and commenting on other players' customizable spaces is a rapidly growing trend in puzzle and sim apps, and has been a major component of recent breakout successes like Redecor, Home Design Makeover. So next time your team is designing a new collection feature, think about ways to make the experience more active and personal. When players have deeper interactions with your collections, they'll find the collectibles more meaningful and will be more motivated to earn them.